Hello, this is Christy. In today's quick tutorial in Camtasia 2020, I will show you how you can create a very simple and quick circular progress bar that you can use in your projects to maybe show a little countdown or just show the progress of an animation or whatever you want. It's very easy to do. So this is going to be a round animation. So we're going to go to the annotations and go to shapes. And we're gonna turn on all the shapes down here in the style, and we can take this circle. It doesn't really matter the color right now. And holding down the control key, we're gonna resize this. Control and shift will resize this and drag the corner as large as you like. You can resize this after that because we will group it. But until then, let's just leave it like this. And just stretch this a bit longer here to about 40 seconds, or maybe that's too much. Let's try 10 seconds right here. Again, this is not important because it can be tweaked later. So I'm just gonna keep it at 10 seconds here. And now here's the tricky part. Here's the part where we actually make this behave like a progress bar. Now it's a circle, but we actually want like just the outline to kind of show spinning and complete the circle, right? Let's do this. Let's take another circle, put it on the timeline here. Let's give it a different color so that we can see the difference. And again, align this in the center and scale it a little bit. Control and shift key, hold down and drag the corner to about here. So what you see here is that yellow part is the sort of the outline, which is the circle behind this one. That's what we're gonna use to show the progress bar. Effect we're gonna use is gonna use this new feature in Camtasia 2020. It's called track mat, right? So what we will do is on the circle at the top, right click on this and select alpha invert. So now this, you see this effect on this track, it actually hides away everything that is in that circle. So that circle becomes opaque in a way. You can see through it, but you cannot see the yellow circle behind it, right? So everything that is in that circle covers is not visible because this is alpha invert. If I had done a different effect, right click and alpha on this, I would only see what is in that circle, right? Because alpha shows you only what is in the surface affected by the object that you have. But we're gonna instead just use alpha invert, right, like this. So we haven't yet finished this effect because we now need to do the animation part, the reveal part, or the part where our circle is being designed or drawn on screen from nothing to a full circle. For this, we will use a transition. So on the bottom object, on the bottom track here, the one that is the yellow circle, we're going to go to transitions and we're going to use the radial wipe. You notice this animation, it kind of goes around like this, and just drag this radial wipe onto that shape and let's play it. Right. So there is the effect. Now, there's one thing we still need to do, and that is make the transition, the radial wipe, last for as long as we need in order to show our progress bar. So notice that when I applied this radial wipe to the object, it added it at the end and at the start. We don't need the one at the end. I'm going to delete this. And the one at the start, because I want to have my animation actually last for the full duration of my clip. And remember, that was 10 seconds. I can adjust this transition to last as long as the clip. So let's play it. So now look, my progress bar, because of this transition, is gonna last 10 seconds for as long as I want, like this. If you want it to last more or less, of course, what you can do is select both clips like this and just make them smaller. Now, because this one has the transition, I can't actually resize it. So I have to first delete the transition and resize my clip to, let's say, 5 seconds. So I'm going to make both clips last 5 seconds. And again, radial wipe on the start of the clip and pull it to all the way to the end. So now my progress bar lasts 5 seconds. See? So that's very easy. And there's nothing stopping you from actually selecting this clip and reversing the animation. So we have radial wipe here. If I click on the reverse, you will see that now my animation goes the other way. You see? Like that. So it can go the other way around. So there you go. That's your progress bar in a circle, progress circle, if you want. Just as I said, you know, you can select your layer at the bottom and change its color. It doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be yellow. You can make it any color. The animation will still work. And the color of the other layer doesn't really matter. So when you're happy with this and you want to reuse it, all you have to do is just select both of these objects and right click and group like this. Let's double click on the group, progress bar, rename it. And now remove the effect from this track because this was the track that we applied the alpha inverse to. Just right click on this eye and just say none. So now my object plus the animation plus the alpha effect is inside this group. So if I want, copy, paste, and copy this, resize it. You know, I can do whatever, and I have two of them. You can reuse it. You can add it to your library if you want. You can make one of them inverted. So open the group, click on the transition, reverse. So look at this very cool effect now, revealing this progress bar. You can add it to your library with, right click, add to library, and then you can reuse it in other projects. So this was very easy, very simple tutorial showing you the progress bar using a radial wipe. I hope you enjoy my tutorials. If you do and you haven't subscribed to my channel, feel free to subscribe, like, and share this video. And if you have any other ideas or questions about this video or other Camtasia videos or tutorials or questions, let me know in the comments and I may do a video about it. Thanks for watching. See you next time.